Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good morning, everybody. Beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning, and it's snowing again outside, mashallah. Anyway, so a lot of you have been asking me to share kind of like some wisdoms, you know, or reflections of, you know, going through being ill and not being able to really do much and, you know, not knowing what's going on. And I thought of this beautiful dua, subhanAllah, that's in Surah Ali Imran, that we say a lot sometimes, and sometimes we use it in the wrong context. But the reason I wanted to share it with you today is because I want you to tell you, or I want to share with you, what happens when you say that dua based on the Quran. So verse 173 of Surah Ali Imran says what? الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. This story or this ayah is talking about Hamra al-Asad, or basically the Battle of Uhud, when, you know, the people who were throwing the arrows left their places, there was confusion, 70 of the Sahaba were killed, the Prophet ﷺ was hurt, his uncle, it was just really bad. And then to top all of this, and this is what the meaning of the ayah says, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ, those who the people told them, Abu Sufyan sent someone, right, to put more fear in the hearts of the believers. And this guy was a hypocrite, and he came and he told what the believers, beware, Abu Sufyan is, you know, is collecting Quraysh, and they're going to come and round you up, right? What, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ, they're gathering, فَخْشَوْهُمْ, so fear them. And the response of the believers was beautiful. What was it? فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. It only increased them in faith, right? We all go through tests and trials. There are times in our lives where we fear. We fear of something. We fear of not getting married, or getting married and then having, you know, maybe, I don't know, an abusive relationship, or not being able to have kids, or having kids but then they're disobedient, or they're ill, or God forbid, losing them, or, you know, losing a job, or having so much money and not knowing to do how to, you know, deal with it. Subhanallah, we're all tested, each and every single one. Do not be deceived by this fake world of social media where you see pictures are perfect and people's lives look perfect. No one, and I'm telling you, no one has a perfect life. This is not Jannah. This is dunya. It's a place of tests and trials. We all get tested and trialed over and over and over. But the response is what? فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. It increases you in faith. It makes you stronger because you know you're getting closer, because the closer you get, the more tested you're going to be by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then they said, what a beautiful dua. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Allah is sufficient for us. Allah is enough for us. And He's the best disposer of affairs. He's the one who's handling our affairs. And who could handle your affairs better than the one who controls the hearts of every creation on this universe? The things that you're afraid of is, you know, or anything, whatever it is that you fear, is in His hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So imagine if He's the one who is handling your affairs. And one of the, you know, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam also as well actually said this dua when he was thrown into what? Into the fire, right? Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Now, Imam Malik used to have a ring that he used to wear, and it had that part of the ayah on it, or the dua, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. And the reason why I want to share this dua with you is because of what comes, why do we say Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel? And when Imam Malik was asked, why do you have these words engraved? He said, because of the ayah that comes after it. What does the ayah say? فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ, right? وَاتَّبَعُوا رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَظِيمٍ. What does this mean? So they returned. When you say حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, the fa here, فَانْقَلَبُوا, is for speed in Arabic. فَانْقَلَبُوا, they returned with bounties from Allah. Imagine when you say حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, right? وَفَضْل, right? And pleasure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lam yamsasum, not, no harm even touched them, right? And then they, what, they followed what, the pleasure of Allah, and He's the possessor of utmost, yani, bounties and what, and so on. So imagine when you say, or when you go through a test and trial in your life, and we all do, you know, we all get tested, and there are times of sadness, there are times of fear, just like we are in right now. We're afraid what's going to happen, this, that, whatever it is that you're going through. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah is sufficient for me, and He is the best disposer of my affairs. And inshallah, we will all, what, nanqalib bi ni'matin min Allah. We're going to return with bounties and favors, not from anyone, but from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator. Repeated often, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.